Thank you for taking some time with us, McGregor W. Scott, the U.S. Attorney for the Eastern District of California, correct?
Yes, sir.
Great. I want to start by talking about what we saw in our nation's capital back on January 6th, the riots going into the Capitol. We saw that the one guy with the bison hat on going in there storming the Capitol. I think it's interesting now that many of these attorneys who are representing these folks who did go in there are saying, well, the president invited us here. What do you think about that kind of a defense and that kind of approach here? Can you give us some insight?
Well, we've anticipated in my circles, we've anticipated since January 6th that that is the defense that would be put up. But that is no defense. These were actions that people took of their own volition. It's not as though the president was there leading them into the Capitol building. And so while it sounds good, it will not be a legal defense to prosecutions that are brought against those who stormed the Capitol last week.
What do you think, as this does continue to play out, how do you think it's going to end up? What kind of repercussions will these folks be facing?
There are literally hundreds of people who are being investigated across the nation for having participated in this riot. There are dozens of people who have already been charged criminally by the United States Attorney's Office in the District of Columbia. The Department of Justice made a strategy call that all of these cases would be prosecuted by the United States Attorney's Office there. That having been said, our local FBI office and my office have a role in helping to facilitate investigations and searches and arrests of people from our part of the world, from the Eastern District of California, who participated in the riots last week. We have dozens of open investigations right now of those persons, and we anticipate that within the next 24 to 48 hours, we will have persons formally charged with crimes from the Eastern District of California who will be having to answer for those charges in Washington, D.C.
And those are people that, who are currently right here, maybe in our North State area, who are amongst us right now, that you're saying here in the next few days will be brought to justice for their alleged role in this.
Yes, sir.
Wow. I know you can't get into the specifics. I know it's open investigation. Could you tell me how many again you're looking at? What was the number?
We have, the FBI currently has, just in rough numbers, dozens of open investigations of persons who we have reason to believe traveled to Washington, D.C. and participated in the riot.
Can you be a little more specific on locations on where these people are? What regions of the area in Northern California they're at?
So the Eastern District of California extends from the Oregon border to the North Los Angeles County line. And these people that I'm talking about literally span the length of the district. So there is no concentration in one particular location. They are people from up and down the Central Valley of California, the North State, the Sacramento region, literally from Siskiyou County to Kern County in the south.
And again, what's the timing again for bringing them to justice or arresting them?
It's going to be one at a time, mm-hmm. but we anticipate that in the next 24 to 48 hours, at least we will start on this process with the first formal charging of a handful of individuals from the Eastern District.
Let me ask you this, sir. With the inauguration tomorrow, big day tomorrow, how critical is it to get some of these arrests made that you're talking about? How dangerous are these people that we are talking about here? Is there a level of concern that something could happen in Sacramento tomorrow?
So the bottom line is that we as Americans must come together tomorrow for a peaceful transfer of power to the new president and his administration, as we have done throughout our history as a nation. And there are those who obviously undertook acts last week in the nation's capital. Law enforcement here in the Sacramento region has spent amazing amounts of time and energy over the last several days ensuring that nothing remotely close to what happened last week in Washington, D.C. will happen here in our state capital. Just this morning, I was out walking around the perimeter of our federal courthouse, greeting and thanking members of our California Army National Guard who are on station helping to protect our federal courthouse. The California Highway Patrol has a major presence here in Sacramento. It has been very quiet thus far, and we are hoping that through this, what I have come to call peace through strength, through a very strong law enforcement and National Guard presence, we will have peace through tomorrow and the inauguration of our new president.
I think one of the other concerns that is out there right now, and we saw it this morning, there are two National Guard members who were moved from the D.C. Capitol, and they're being investigated right now for what we're still learning what they're being investigated for, but the bottom line is they were removed and they're being investigated. Is there any indication that any of that's happening here with our National Guard in Sacramento?
I'm unaware of what's happened in Washington. That's the first I've heard that. I certainly have heard absolutely nothing remotely close to that with respect to the Guard's presence here in Sacramento. I will tell you, visiting with these young men this morning, they are great Americans, and they have a very important job to do, and they take it with the utmost seriousness, and they will guard and they will protect our state's capital.
I want to expand upon that a little bit, because it's a great point as you're talking to them. What's the psychology like for them? You know, this is unlike anything, you know, we've ever seen in our lifetime for sure. We have our National Guard's troops, you know, deployed across the country right now, defending our country against our own people, if you will, in a way. It is so much different than if they were deployed to Afghanistan or Iraq. What is the mental status from some of the troops that are out there right now that you talk to? Can you talk about that a little bit?
Yeah, so Scott, it's interesting. One of the sergeants that I talked to this morning said that he had been here in June during the civil unrest following the death of George Floyd, mm-hmm. guarding our federal courthouse. So, you know, twice in 6 or 7 months, he's right. here in this situation guarding governmental buildings and structures to prevent any damage or looting or rioting. So I think, you know, we've seen, I myself went to Los Angeles in 1992 with the National Guard mm-hmm. after mm-hmm. the verdict in the Rodney King case and the riots there. So this is, I'm not gonna say it's a normal role, but it is something that the Guard does and does well. I think what's different this time is the fact that a group of people were able to take over the nation's capital. That is just stunning. It is shocking, almost incomprehensible. And so that's what's different. And so the pre-deployment of the National Guard before any trouble happened here in Sacramento, I commend the governor for that. I think it was the right decision to put the Guard out on the streets in advance of trouble, rather than waiting for trouble and trying to get a situation back under control after you've lost control. So that sense of strength, as I said earlier, I think will inspire peace throughout our region.
Well put, thank you. You know, a couple more questions here, I'll let you run. We saw the pictures over the past couple of days of the woman that the FBI are looking for right now. She's accused of stealing a laptop. Sensitive information on that laptop. How concerning is that to our national security? Not just the laptop, but all of the classified documents that were in the Capitol there that these folks had access to. They were taking pictures of these classified documents. How concerning is that for our national security?
Well, I don't have any information other than what I have read and seen in the media about this stolen laptop. So I have no idea. I have no inside baseball on how much national security matters may have been on the laptop. But obviously, this is of great concern. And it really, I think, is why the FBI is laser focused right now on identifying each and every one of these people who broke into the Capitol last week and finding them, interviewing them, taking back things like laptops or documents that they may have, and why the United States Attorney's offices around the country are supporting our brothers and sisters in the Washington, D.C. U.S. Attorney's Office to bring these people to justice. I can't really hazard any guess as to whether or not crucial national security documents may have been taken. I just simply don't know the answer to that. But we're not going to take any chances, and we're going to do everything we can to locate these people and find out exactly what they may have taken from the Capitol last week.
You know, I think there's no question that the rhetoric started this riot on Capitol Hill on January 6th. Do you think it's time for every single lawmaker in the House and the Senate to step up and say enough is enough? We need a smooth transition of power, because not all of them have done that yet, including one of our North State congressmen right here.
It's time for all of us to recognize that Mr. Biden won the election. He will be our president starting at noon Eastern time tomorrow. And all of us, whether it's this specific issue or the broader panoply of issues in which we seem to constantly fight each other, we need to just all take a step back and recognize that what we have here in the United States of America is a very precious, unique thing. And we're playing with around the edges here of losing that precious, unique thing. We have to remember we are all Americans, and we all need to represent and stand up for this nation and stop fighting each other.
Just personally, do you think it's possible to mend that deleterious divide that's out there right now?
I don't know, but we certainly have to give it our very best shot, because we have been handed something from our ancestors, people who fought for this nation, people who sacrificed, people who, you know, in the words of the Declaration of Independence, their lives, their fortunes, and their sacred honor to give to us the greatest democratic republic in the history of the world. And we, it's our obligation. We are the ones presently charged with protecting and safeguarding this nation. And it's our job to do that and hand it to those who come after us as it was handed to us.
Great. Anything else you would like to add, sir?
No, Scott, I appreciate the opportunity very much.
Absolutely. McGregor W. Scott, thank you for the time, sir. Have a good day. Stay safe
tomorrow.
Thank you.
Okay? Take care.
Yep. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.